In this video, I'm going to talk about why selling is just a game. So there's six things I'm going to talk about when it talks to becoming better at selling. Now, the first thing you want to think about is kind of like a cat and a mouse chase. Cat's always chasing a mouse. You're always chasing sales. And if you could think about it, when selling, one of the most biggest things you want to focus on is the follow-up, right? You're always got to be followed. So if you look at the film or the cartoons, Tom and Jerry, you know, in the olden days, for those of you who are young enough or old enough, shall I say, it's always a chase, isn't it? Like, we always want to chase that sale, but it's following up that's the key. So there's a saying that says the fortune is in the follow-up, meaning that we want to keep following up with that sale no matter what. And you want to touch on multiple different ways. For example, following up on email, following up on a phone call, following up on a text message, on a WhatsApp, on a Facebook message, an Instagram message, on a LinkedIn message, and following up on retargeting, following on a text message, following on some kind of a group, you know, connecting with people. So these are some of the ways that you want to follow up. And we're always going to be chasing the mouse, but doing it elegantly. Number two tip is the first to speak losers. For example, if you've ever been in negotiations, someone ever asks you, well, for example, in real estate, So someone says, based on what you are going to offer, how much you're going to offer. Or if you're in negotiation for like percentage of the company, for example, let's say you're doing a company negotiation. So if they say to you, so what percentage you're looking for, and then you can, and then what you should always reply is, well, what percentage do you think is fair? So you get them to tell you what percentage be willing to offer, because you just never know that what you have in your mind, it might be different to their mind, because if they speak first, then you can always adjust it from there. Whereas if you speak first, it's much harder to go back. So especially in the negotiation or sales, make sure that you're not the first to name the price. And number three is make sure that when you are looking to sell and improve more, it's like a game. Like, it's like social media. One of the best ways to sell is to sell on social media. This concept is known as social selling. How do we sell on social media in such a way that we monetize? So for example, I'll give you a really good tip to do that. First of all, you want to use Facebook, LinkedIn, YouTube, is what we call the fly strategy, and the GTI, which is Google, Twitter or TikTok, and Instagram game, right? So these are six top platforms that you want to focus on to actually start posting your selling. But it's not selling in the traditional sense where, you know, it's like, oh, this is for sale, buy this. No one's going to do that. The type of selling you want to do is what we call educational selling. So we're going to educate people, and then we're going to pose a question at the end. So for example, I might do a whole piece on, for example, knowing your ideal client. So my ideal client is someone's got a business, but they want to take it to the next level, and they know that social media is going to be the way to give them more exposure to do that. Or someone who's got no business, but they would like to start a business, and they've got an idea for a business, but they're just not sure how to do it. So these are my ideal audience. So that's why all the content I put out is about this. And at the end, I'll say, by the way, if you need more help with your business, then make sure that you click the link below and you can speak to one of my coaches, and they'll be able to give you some, you know, suggestions on how to do this. So it's a really great way to filter out people who content is really your filter. That's how you got to think about it. So that's how you increase your sales through selling on social media. Fourth tip I have for you is part of the game is actually knowing when to close the sale. So there's a saying that says if you close too early, then you're going to get a lot of resistance. If you close too late, you may have wasted a lot of time. So better thing rather than just closing is you want to keep test closing all the way through. Let's say I'm negotiating a property deal, right? Because I'd use property because it's my industry. So I'll say something like, so based on what I've told you, would you be willing to accept a quick sale in order to complete very, very quickly, but you know, there will be a discount to the market? Yes or no? They'll say yes or no. Or I might say something like, well, you know, if we could do this for you, then would you do that? And if we did this, would that mean this? And you just want to get a lot of these yeses, because you want an indication of whether you're going the right way. So test closing is part of the game. It's kind of like when you go on a date, isn't it? You may eye contact with someone, you know, in a restaurant or a club or at a party, and then that person gives you the wink. You know, it's kind of like an invite, and you speak to them and tend to get on, and you ask them out, and then so on and so forth, right? So it's like one long close, if you will. So you got to make sure that you got to know when to close, because closing is all about timing. Part of the game is knowing the timing and feeling. So what's one really good way where people, when it's a good time to close, is when they start asking you questions about the price, right? So how much does it cost, right? Because that means they're considering it, but if it's too expensive, you know, it's going to be a price objection. So, or they'll say things like, you know, if we did this, and how fast could it happen? These are what we call consideration questions, which will get you closer to that goal of closing the sale. Okay, tip number five is always winners and there's always losers. But what you want to do is you never want to make a loser if you're closing the sale. You want to make what we call a win-win sale. You win, you get what you want, and they win, they get what they want. And one of the best negotiation outcomes is when they feel they've got the better end of the deal. Maybe sometimes they have got the better end of the deal because they've got what they want. So as long as they get what they want, you can get what you want. So for example, again, when one of the property deals I was negotiating, one of the things that she wanted was to move out really quick and complete and basically not have the hassle to move to another house in terms of like moving all the things herself. So I said, look, why don't I buy the house from you and I'll move everything from this house into your new house and it'll be done in 30 days. And then she said, yes. So that's part of the negotiation is finding out what they want. They don't mind giving you a discount to the market if they're getting what they want. I know this may sound far-fetched for those of you who've never heard this before, but I can tell I've been doing this for over a decade and I know it works. I've proven, I've tried it and it works. So find out what they want, give it to them as long as you can get what you want, right? In fact, you might even say that. You say, look, what do you want? I'm willing to give you what you want as long as I can get what I want. That's how you balance it up. And tip number six, there's so many levels of selling. For example, there's pre-selling in your marketing. There's language, what words you say. There's different closing techniques. There's conviction, there's delivery, there's visual, auditory, and kinesthetic selling. There's so many different styles of selling. There's hard selling, there's soft selling, there's reverse selling. You gotta look at what is right for your brand and also who you're speaking to. Depending on who you're speaking to means you need to adapt like a chameleon, right? You know how a chameleon changes colors? If someone's asking a lot of like detailed questions, you gotta give a lot of detailed answer because these people are very, what we call digital, right? So you have people that just want the big picture. That's why when you sell to people sometimes, you know, and you're giving them big picture and they're asking you like, okay, so all the detailed questions. But if someone's not a detailed person, you say, and then they just want to know, okay, what's this about? You start getting into it, into all the details, they're not listening to you. So you want to give the big picture first. Maybe they're what I call the opposite. So you tell them something, they always give you the opposite. So you have to give them the opposite to give you the right answer. Sometimes you've got people who are completion orientated, so they need to complete the whole process before they can actually go ahead with the sale. Some people have to learn from other people, as in like have a recommendation. Some people make a decision inside. So there's so many different levels of selling. That's why it's so important to know new styles and new techniques to be able to do this. But ultimately, it comes from within. And the best way to sell is to sell with conviction and authenticity. Coming from a point where you are truly trying to help that client out by buying your product, you know, it's really going to help them. So I think that's one of the reasons why I've done well in business, because I truly believe in what I sell and I stand by it. You see a lot of people when they sell things, they go, it's kind of knocking on the door like this, look. And it's like saying, oh, you wouldn't want to buy this, would you? And there's that resistance. So make sure that you're truly convicted what you sell and it can really bring value to people's lives. So by the way, if you love this content, I'm going to be producing more stuff on how different levels of selling. Make sure you hit the subscribe button and turn on bell notifications or follow me wherever you're following or listening this on maybe in a podcast. And also make sure you hit the like button as well. So it shows some of the algorithm will show you more of my content. And if you've got any questions whatsoever, leave a question on this page. And my name is John Lee, the author of Business Hack. I'll see you in the next session. Bye for now.